gentlemen, welcome to the commencement exercises for the Brattleboro Union High School class of 1995. Thank you. change in the program, Ian Stearns will present the national anthem.
I pledge allegiance to the flag, the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to graduation ceremony for class of 1995. Tonight we share an evening with you that celebrates a passage in our lives that is not only a transitional time for the graduates, but also for the families. For the graduates, today marks the beginning of an incredible journey. A Russian fairy tale suggests that we go, not knowing where, bring, not knowing what. The path is long, away unknown. It is this unknowing that makes this time so exciting. It is a chance for all of us to find our own path. For perhaps the first time in our lives, the journey ahead has no markers to guide our trail, no boundaries to restrict our ways, and only our own expectations to influence our travels. For you, the friends and family, it is time to watch your kids move on, to adjust to small, quieter houses. And graduates, as you embark on your lifelong trek, remember, it is good to have an end to journey cord, but it is the journey that matters in the end. Thank you. today you see before you a group of young people dedicated to many wonderful things, things that many people have lost sight of long ago. The people sitting before you merit such anomalous values as friendship, respect, cooperation, honesty, and working for the common cause. A group that is laughed in the face of conformity and taken many a pie in the face for individuality. Yet as an individual as we may be in our own person, it is together that we are reborn into this world of Cain. It is as a pack that we will survive this dog-eat-dog world, and it is as a pack that we will send the world a message of hope and faith in the new generation. Like those before us, we have been handed the torch. This is our torch to do it as we please, yet it is our responsibility to carry this torch with the dignity and class of those before us. It is our responsibility to speak loud and clear with the common voice that we have earned at our tenor of It is our responsibility to put behind us the mistakes of the past and forge ahead, creating a world that will be safe for many generations to follow on this field and the billions of others who walk a similar path on this earth. A wise philosopher once said, "Be like the tree." Actually, it was Jason Hale sitting over there somewhere. She said, "Stand firm in the face of the oncoming seasons and weather the adversity of the impending storm life bringeth forth. Become the sapling, searching to find your own spot of sun in the ever-crowding forest. Spread your branches as your roots become ever more deep and find that which you most desire. Let the soil that has been provided nourish your growth and provide the nutrients you find necessary." I myself find the tree metaphor to work in the cheesy Zen sort of way, but as a general framework for life, life often becomes a little more complicated than roots and branches. Would you agree? I found the metaphors just basically don't fit into a framework of life. For speeches, they're pretty much ideal, but they allow the speaker to speak about people without directly addressing the actual species. This problem with a metaphor is life is not a metaphor. Life is every day. Life is hitting the snooze bar 17 times before you wake up every morning. Life is arriving late to class, only to find your papers signed 3 weeks ago is due and you don't know what it's supposed to be about. Life is 99 cent bacon double cheeseburgers. Life is that freak boy smile in your senior pictures. Life is like a box of chocolates. You need to squeeze each and every one to see which ones you want to eat. Life is a Chad Emery home run ball sailing over the fence in right field and smashing her car windshield into a billion shiny pieces. Life is standing in a podium in front of several thousand people and realizing you were about to life is also realizing that the end of your speech is pretty poor. I sort of did a number on the whole metaphor thing earlier, and I'm about to become the ultimate hypocrite as I
dive into one right here. I was thinking that high school is much like a train. And when you're sort of a freshman, you hop on the train, all aboard, you're on the train. And it's moving slow, but you're psyched. Sophomore year, you get up to speed a little bit, so it's really going in. Then you're moving along, and it's getting faster and faster, and you're realizing that things are picking up, and then you're like, yeah, and then you're a junior, and you are pushing the train. You are moving, you're pushing with all your might, all of a sudden, when you're a senior, you're holding on to that baby for dear life. You're cruising along, you're holding the train, yeah, and you're thinking, oh my god, the G-forces! You're holding the train, January, February, March, April, May, and then June, bam, graduation crew, thank you very much.
favorite word, lila, which means play. Richer than our word, it means divine play, the play of creation, destruction, and recreation. Lila, free and deep, is the enjoyment and delight of this moment. Lila may be the simplest thing there is, spontaneous, childish, disarming. But as we grow and experience the complexities of life, it may also be the most difficult and hard-won achievement imaginable. This is an excerpt from the prologue to Free Play by Stephen McManus. The prologue goes on to relate this concept to music, but I think it's also very relevant to life in general. Children's play. When we're young, we have no problem just playing and enjoying the moment at hand without concern for society or the great doings of the world. But as we grow and get a little older, we realize that we're worrying about what people think of us. We don't want to be seen as children anymore, so we stop playing. Then we get to the stage that I'm at now. We realize just how many things there are to worry about, and we wish that we could forget it all. And play again. What we don't necessarily realize, though, is that we can. Even with our schedules that are packed so tightly we can barely breathe sometimes, there's always time to play. I think that too many people get trapped in the routine and the rush and the worries of everyday life. I know I do. There are so many places I'm supposed to be, so many people I'm supposed to be seeing, so many things I'm supposed to be doing all at the same time. I feel like I'm drowning in some sort of vast societal ocean. And just when I think I've got my head up high enough to take a breath, that the wave comes by and washes me under again. But what we have to realize in life gets like that is that we have the power to tame the ocean. It sounds impossible. But it can be done. The key is in the child playing in the sandbox, or climbing a tree, or coloring in a coloring book. The child isn't worrying, just playing, just enjoying the moment at hand. You don't have to set aside specific times to play, but sometimes the best opportunities to play come in the most humdrum of daily activities. As Reggie alluded to, getting up in the morning can be awful for a lot of people. So as you're stumbling around trying to wake up, sing a song you used to love when you were little, or blow bubbles in your milk, or just make a funny face. There are all kinds of little things you can do to make a dull moment fun. And you'd be surprised how much it helps. The world just seems a little brighter after you've done something mindless and silly. So to all the people, like me, who've grown up a little too much to play all the time, and to all the people who think there's no escape from the monotony and the burdens of life, I say leave. Play.
While this graduation exercise is the culmination of 4 years of secondary education for these young adults who are about to receive their diplomas, it is fitting that tonight we also recognize the achievement of a number of individuals of the class of 1995. At this time, we would like to congratulate all of those individuals who received awards at the Senior Awards Assembly last night, and of all the individuals who have earned the following awards and prizes as outlined in your program. The four recipients of the 1995 Austin Prize are Kara Blue Adams, Elsa Marie Lorette, Edward Andrew Richards, and Jeanette Marie Stafford. Kendall Scholarship is awarded to Benjamin M. Ago. There are three Harry E. Clark scholarships, which this year are given to Andrew N. Mangum, Ariane Elizabeth Richards, Taina Yendi Rodriguez.
The next award is the Lieutenant Colonel George M. Brutus Award. The first award for excellence in athletics is given to Andrew J. Stockwell. Second award given to a girl for outstanding scholarship is to Eleanor S. Cartelli. Third award is given to a boy for outstanding scholarship, Timothy Charles Baker. Fourth student is given an award for scholarship and service that goes to Stephanie White Bowman. The Harold Wagner Memorial Award, presented by the class of 1925, is presented to Frederick William Kendall III. Good evening. On behalf of the BHS-BUHS alumni, officers, and board, I would like to congratulate the class of 1995 on your achievements and wish you good luck in the future. We would like to welcome you as the newest members to the Alumni Association of BUHS. As in the past, the Alumni Association is pleased to present two $1,000 scholarships, one to a high school graduate and one to a career center graduate. In 1994, the Alumni Association renamed one of our scholarships in memory of Natalie Alexander Wellman. Natalie was a 1945 graduate of Brattleboro High School and served for many terms and held various offices in the Alumni Association. She had been our historian for many years and was responsible for collecting the vast amount of memorabilia that we now have in our file. A plaque bearing the name of the recipient for this scholarship will be displayed at the high school. The 1995 recipient of the Natalie Alexander Wellman Alumni Scholarship will be attending the University of New Hampshire and majoring in recreational management. It is a great honor that we present this year's scholarship to Shelby Hamilton. Our second scholarship is given to a Career Center person and has been named in memory of our past president, John J. Oziak, Jr. A plaque bearing the name of the recipient for this scholarship will be displayed at the Career Center. Here to present the scholarship in John's memory is Virginia Oziak.
Mechanics and craftspeople who keep everything going and in working order. The people who build and fix things. With the expanding technology and training necessary to do this work, trade schools and technical schools are more essential than ever. John Oziak appreciated the contribution that these people make and felt that deserving students going into these fields should be recognized. I would like to present the John J. Oziak, Jr. Alumni Career Center Scholarship to Ian McNulty, who will be attending Vermont Technical College in Randolph, Vermont, to study electrical engineering.
The Diedrich Schulte Memorial Cup is presented this year to two individuals, Sarah Marie Tony and Edward Andrew Drew Richards. The Arthur J. Monroe Cup is presented to Jeffrey B. Henry.
There are two Lundberg prizes, this year presented to Edward Andrew Richards and Jeanette Marie Saffer. This year's principal trophy is given to Jessica L. Poole. 1942 In Memoriam Trophy and Scholarship is presented to Christy Diane LeClaire.
It is now my pleasure to present to you Mr. Roger Quadro, Chairman of the Brattleboro Union High School Board of Directors, who will present the 1995 School Directors Award.
Thank you, Mr. Sprague. It's a pleasure to give this award tonight, and it's given to a young man who's dependable, cooperative, and who's well-liked for his friendly personality, warm sense of humor, and sincere loyalty to his friends. His self-sufficient sense of fair play, personal honesty, and integrity have made him respected for his character by all who know him. His strong sense of initiative, dedication to the completion of tasks, and responsibility of action have enabled him to serve both Brattleboro Union High School and the community at large in many useful and important capacities. This award is given to Kelly Michael Hannon.
Thank you, Mr. Quadro. I will now officially recognize some new awards. These will be given out in ensuing years at the Senior Awards Night. The first new award is the Jennifer Murphy Scholarship. This is sponsored by the BUHS Student Council through their own effort and also through a donation from the Thomas Thompson Trust. It will be presented by Stephanie Bonin, Emily Pettit, and Melinda Morrill.
In doing so, we also not only created the first Student Council Scholarship, but also the first scholarship to be designed, funded, chosen, and awarded by students. We are so happy that our efforts were so successful and that we accomplished our goal of creating a tribute to them. On behalf of the Student Council and the many awardees to come, I would like to thank the Thomas Thompson Trust Fund for their most generous matching contribution. And I would also like to thank all of you who so generously gave to help us achieve and surpass our goals. Your help has made this a very special day. And now we ask you to please join us in a moment of remembrance.
Butterfield was a science teacher at BUHS for 32 years. He received many, many distinctions and awards for his service, for his work with students. But no award, I'm sure Charlie would agree, was greater than the fulfillment that he got from working with students and from working with his colleagues. It's a real honor for me to welcome back Charlie to give this first Charles H. Butterfield Award.
My best wishes for the class of 1995. Some of you must be surprised to see me here tonight. But you can't be as surprised as I am to find myself here tonight. It came as a complete surprise to me. And I felt a very great honor when I learned that former students and my teaching colleagues and my friends in the community had contributed to a fund which makes this award possible. And it will come as a surprise to the senior because the award was not announced and there was no application process. A committee of teachers went looking for one of you who met certain criteria. That senior would show enthusiasm for learning in a number of fields, would work to very high standards, and would not only welcome new ideas, but would work to bring change to the school. You'll agree that's a tall order, but one of you clearly met the criteria. And as pleased as I am to be honored by my friends in this way, it gives me even greater pleasure to announce that the recipient of the Charles H. Butterfield Award is Timothy Baker. Memorial Award to be presented by her niece, Nancy Depp, niece of Mrs. Connors.
I feel really privileged to be here in memory of my aunt Helen Connors. Her children and herself were born and raised in West Brattleboro Town School, some of them also to the high school. Children went very diverse directions. One, a police officer.
L. Dale and Evelyn L. Cleveland Memorial Trust Fund for Students of Music. Gerald Dale was a local resident who had a great love of music in the students of Brattleboro Union High School. These scholarships are provided through a trust fund which he established, and they are intended for students who have demonstrated excellence in the general field of music, with secondary consideration being given to academic excellence, school and community activity, and financial needs. They are being presented for the first time this year. The recipients of the Errol Dale and Evelyn Cleveland scholarships are Gabriel John Contravitz, Timothy Charles Baker, Eleanor F. Cartelli, Matthew James Cronk, Shelby Marie Hamilton, Eric Howard Haskins, John Walter Mulhall, Jamie Lynn Munich, Jeanette Marie Stafford, and Ian C. Stearns. Thank you. And we now have two awards which will be given out this year. The first award is presented by the BOHS class of 1970, and it will be presented by Nikki Dio.
We shared a number of different traits, both individually and collectively. Conscientious, determined, hardworking, enthusiastic, respectful of individual rights, and yes, even way back then, a significant social consciousness. As we went about the truly painstaking task of selecting the recipients of our scholarship, for every application we received was truly impressive and showed tremendous initiative and sense of purpose, for which I personally want to commend you all. We found that all of you, in some demonstrable way, exemplified the unique spirit of our class. How we wished that we could have somehow recognized you all. But alas, we somehow managed to narrow the choice to two outstanding young men and an equally impressive young lady, all of whom I am delighted to recognize herewith. They are Chad Michael Emery, Michael Andrew Putnam, and Jesse Catherine Krause. Those of you know me well know probably all too well that there's no way they're going to get me off this podium without offering some kind of parting shot of wisdom and advice. Unfortunately, the maxims that I selected were unilaterally vetoed by certain members of my family as being too heavy and profound. And so, courtesy of Adam, Evan, and the class of 1970, I give you the sentiments and wisdom of the esteemed Dr. Seuss, with apologies for being redundant, and to Mr. Lewis as well. Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away. On and on you will hike, and I know you will hike far, and face up to your problems, whatever they are. You'll get mixed up, of course, as you already know. You'll get mixed up with many strange birds as you go. But be sure when you step with care and great tact, and remember that life's a great balancing act. Just never forget to be dexterous and deft, and never mix up your right foot with your left. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98.75% guaranteed. Kid, you'll move mountains. So be your name Buxbaum or Bixby or Bray or Mordecai Ali Van Allen O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So get on your way. Peace, guys.
Award to be presented this evening is the Madeline Moore Scholarship. It will be presented by Barbara Rao.
Madeline Moore began working for the Wyndham Southeast Supervisory Union 28 years ago. She started in the junior high as the registrar and later moved to the senior high as secretary to the headmaster. A few years later, Madeline went on to the supervisory union office to be secretary to the superintendent. On March 12th of this year, Madeline passed away. Madeline Moore Scholarship Award for $1,650, which will be presented tonight, is made available in appreciation, love, and friendship from Madeline's co-workers, family, and friends. It is my pleasure to present this award to Tara Lee Brissett.
Mr. Quadro, Mr. Malin, Mr. Heller, and I present to you the class of 1995. We certify that these students have met the requirements for graduation as stipulated by the Brattleboro Union High School Board of Directors and the State of Vermont, and recommend that they be awarded their diplomas. Cheryl Libidorny and Robert Kramsky will read the names. Mr. McNulty and Mr. Quadro will present the diplomas. We ask everyone to please withhold their applause until all graduates have received their diplomas.
With honors. Isabel Nolasco Williams, with honors. Brenda Lynn Siegel. Jessie Catherine Kraus, with honors. Cheryl M. Klein, with honors. Anna Hall Jerome. Ariane Elizabeth Richards, with honors. Lisa Marie Jay. Jessica Joanne Scott. Katie Lynn Gilbert. Benjamin Eaton Kelly, with honors. Kelly Michael Hannum, with honors. Jeanette Marie Stafford, with honors. William J. Osterhout. Joshua Justin Lamoureux. Diksha Kumar Rajim Mishra, with honors. Jessica Judy Eaton, with honors. Holly F. Candon. Timothy Dennis Wood. Ethan Drew Lumen, with honors. Gail M. Langlois. Nadine Ray Lyman. Eleanor F. Cartelli, with honors. Antoinette C. Place. Heather R. Gerard. Kimberly A. Belleville, with honors. Tamara M. Similcare. Joy Jero Belleville. Faith Ann Rose. Darlene Michelle Sanders. Jeremy Michael Beswick. Frederick William Kendall III, with Career Center honors. Stephen Michael Robinson. Andrew J. Stockwell, with honors. Jason A. Peters. Anthony Joseph Volcano. Thomas E. Lewis, Jr. Matthew Matthew P. Rabine. Kenneth A. Roachford, Jr. Joyce Vicky Sweeney. Hope Elizabeth Cardner. Karen Michelle Cratel. Tabitha May Bailey. Amber L. Newton. Teresa Marie Robertson Tinkham. Sheila A. Lindzel. Angela M. Lake. Tara Lee Brissett. James Paul Gagnon, with honors. John Walter Mulhall, with honors. David Scott, with Career Center honors. Rodney Colin Johnson, Jr. Timothy R. Fisher. Jeremiah J. Parker. Kenneth Allen Wells II. Kevin M. Martin. Jamie V. Zataka. Michael Darcy. Danielle Lee La Liberté, with honors and with Career Center honors. Tiffany Ann Rogers. Cara Celeste Tonneson. Jolie A. Lozon. Amanda Lynn Sabo. Susan Elaine Carr. Alicia Ann Saunders. Sarah Lee Green. Kara Adams, with honors. Satjot Kaur Khalsa. Michael David Greenleaf. Mark S. Eatonsey. Stephen D. Howard. Joseph Corey Michael, with Career Center honors. Anthony Michael Wright. Gregory B. Lawrence. Benjamin M. Agos, with honors. Christopher W. Cummings. Christopher Russell Ellis with honors. Matthew James Prompt. Melinda Sue Morrill with honors. Stephanie White Bonin with honors. Elizabeth Ehrenberg with honors. Heather Marie Stokes. Emily Catherine Pettit. Vanessa Marie Arms. Shannon Marie Holland. Melissa S. Hickey. Angela Christine Fish with honors. Hillary Cameron Switzer. Jeffrey B. Henry with honors. Drew Richards with honors. Mark Vito Spino with honors. Adam S. Kelly with honors. Sean Joseph McNulty.
The third is very important. Was that okay?
Yeah. Reginald William Arthur Martell III. Chad Michael Emery with honors. Ian M. McNulty. Trevor J. Golding. Stephen D. Arcalian. Aaron F. Scott. Taina Yendi Rodriguez with honors. Aaron M. Snarsky with honors. Jessica Lynn Poole. Sarah Marie Tony with honors. Becky A. Roberts with honors. Shelby Marie Hamilton with honors. Allison B. Kesson with honors. Luciana Maria Gambino. Sarah Elizabeth White. Michael R. Pasternak with honors. Michael J. Corey with honors. Nathaniel E. North with honors. Todd Andrew Bassler. Seth W. Christmas with honors. Russell John Rosinski with honors. Jeremy Daniel Zabriskie. Kevin Michael Brown with honors. Matthew C. Smith. Yeah. Jeffrey A. Tishner. Rena Ray Woods. Jill Elizabeth Masali. Shayna I. Murphy. Amy Beth Wood, with honors. Meredith Renee Kendrick. Amy Marie Millerick, with honors. Margie Brown, with honors. Laura Forst, with Career Center honors. Desiree Johnson. J.W. Covey. Joshua A. Squires. Timothy Charles Baker, with honors.
Tim.
Eric Howard Haskins, with honors. Andrew N. Mangum, with honors.
Andy.
Keith R. Woods. Michael R. Smith. Philip D. Thomas. Justin Richard Ockington. Catherine Barrington Nephew King. Allison Lynn Mizuki, with honors. Courtney M. Vernon. Emily Suzanne Howe. Maura Ann Carey. Lorraine Smith. Stephanie Renee Hazelton. Heidi Ann Palmer. Tina Marie Hall Surprise, with honors and with Career Center honors. Tyler P. Gibbons, with honors. Brooke Boardman. Stephen M. Venema, with honors. Edward E. Lashway. Anthony Stephen Zimbruski. Stephen M. Serringer. Jason W. Wells. Joshua A. King. Christopher Chad Bass. Susan Marie Holland. Kimberly Ann Parsons, with honors. Renee April Porter, with honors. Idalia Cordova. Melody B. Ellis. Tammy Momini. Heather L. Rabidoux. Christy Gail Smart, with honors and Career Center honors. Winona A. Unwin. Jonathan Stephen Wilson, with Career Center honors. Chad Andrew Corbeil. Gabriel John Contravis, with honors. Jason A. Hale. Eric Hans Hoyer, with honors. Ian B. Stearns, with honors. Trevor William Scherer, with honors. Nathan M. McGinn, with honors. Jason James Powell, with honors. Jamie A. Vigneault. Laura Nicole Sears. Julie Mayberry Emery. Karen Leslie Dodge, with honors. Jamie Lynn Mudick, with Career Center honors. Kelly Angela Palmer. Layla Caldwell. Andrea Lynn Kasich. Hannah Mae Parker. Travis A. Carpenter.
Thanks a lot.
Clinton B. Kerber.
Sam Jonah.
Graham Jonah Borst. Robert F. Knapp. Jason C. Kaplan. Brian D. Lewis. Stacy F. Fairbanks, with honors. Jason Matthew Brown. Gregory Morano. Brenda Lee Patton. Samantha I. Bacon. Christy Diane LeClaire. Elizabeth A. Codman. Michael Shane McGuire. Christopher L. Clues. James Francis Fian. Christopher Jonathan Whitney. Michael Andrew Putnam, with honors. Matthew J. Reed. Kyle Lewis LeClaire. Joshua Michael Tondry. Matthew J. Cody. Also graduating this evening in absentia, Heidi Marie Barrows, Raylene S. Bell, Marika Elise Bullman, Matthew Adams Carroll with honors, Karen Lynn Caruso, Sharon Ann Caruso, Wei Ting Chen, Roy Ying Chen, Thomas F. Class, Gail Kelly Connolly, Dan Paul Daughtry, Joshua L. Green, Diane I. Hart, Aaron Stephanie Haskins, Terry Lynn Hopta, Ishvara Atmananda Levitt with honors, Paibun Lukamhan, Catherine McCarthy, John Christopher Moriarty, Carol Bowman Powers, Jeffrey Daniel Putnam with honors, Dale Robert Rouleau, Christopher John Waite. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present the class of 1995.
Can you all?